Hey, down here. Okay, so that's the IBM that was my web server for years. It's out in the garage, been waiting on me to. I really plan on bringing it back in once I get the Pro Max set up out here. This is where it's going to sit, right there in that spot. And the one on the right is a gateway. 1.7 gigahertz, single core. I haven't done anything with it yet except for check it out. An old monitor that I use out here. The two old gateways, Pentium 3s. My mosquito candle. Yeah, it's January 9th or 10th, and we got mosquitoes down here in North Texas. And I have a couple of WYSE wind terms that they only have, oddly enough, 512 megabytes of IDE flash memory. At that time when these were built, you know, not too awful long ago, that's all they needed. It had WinXP. I don't know if you can see that or not. Let's see. That might be just enough, but not too much light. It had Windows XP. They call it a win term, and it's an enterprise edition. And actually, messing with those is how I learned how to set XP to get security updates. There's one of those mosquitoes. Security updates until, well, a few months now, 2019, but I've been getting my security updates all this time. Oh yeah, and this is my old Harman Kardon amp. I don't know why I'm showing it around the garage. I guess because I talk about it, but I never show it. My toolbox of end wrenches and socket sets. Anyway, on our broken Sears microwave, Kenmore, piece of junk from the day one. Finally quit working all together. Never did cook right. Had that auto-sensing stuff that didn't work right. But I got my blazer, the battery charger on my blazer the other day. I realized that out there beyond the junk, I realized that then I started peeling around. I thought, well, I'm going to wait. I was just going to go right back in, but I thought, well, I could peel around. It hit me. See, I'm dying to have a server out here and turn off that red black battle star in my room. I thought, well, why don't I just put, I'm really thinking seriously about just putting something on, like Fedora 29 basic, you know, no desktop, nothing on this. And usually I didn't grab the other camera with the tall tripod because I really didn't think I was going to do any of this, and now I'm starting to do it. I could shut the, It's not cold, but the mosquitoes are starting to come in here, so I think I'll shut the big door. All I got is a really hard to know where to aim the camera. All I've got is a, you know, big extension cord going out the door, but I just remember how I used to use this ladder to do my videos. Before I figured out how to use the okay, now I think I can aim, set this tripod on here. Aim this thing. Oh, sorry. Very bad. Very bad, very bad. Okay. Doesn't make it any better to say very bad, does it? Okay, so now I can sit down there and you can basically see what I'm doing. I didn't want to spend hours getting things set up to do. Well, I can't stream from out here yet. I still don't. I might be able to when I get my better router put up out here, but I just realized something. Is that turned on? I gotta turn on the router. I just realized I brought out the net install image. I don't know if there'll be enough speed out here. I was only getting about 2 megabits to do do the net install. I don't have the stuff hooked up. That can do it. This will spin all the way around. I don't need these gloves anymore. I was wearing them to mess with the battery. Yeah, that was real good to put them back on. I wasn't really messing with it. I was just checking it and stuff. To charge it up, get charged up. The ones that I used for the battery are not the ones to use for anything at all else. So I think I'll put them over there. That'll hopefully remind me that those are probably too dirty to use for anything else. Get this monitor cable hooked up. This one won't even stay running anymore. Let's see. What do I have? I have a little USB sound, and I have... pretty sure that cable right there is... Oh. Oh, that's those USB speakers. Dang it, now I can't see. This used to have a light on it, and it don't work anymore. I would do that. See if that camera will help me see. I just need to see which one is which. I cannot see. I didn't pay attention because I didn't think I was putting it back. I didn't remember. I thought I remembered how I had things hooked up, but I didn't remember. The WYSEs would be, they're not really, they're only 1 gigahertz. They're not good enough for my web server anyway. They're, what are they? Single core. You know, those processors are in the Pentium 4 class. I don't know that much. I don't know if they're Pentium 4s. I don't know where I've got. I must have that sound plugged in for this one here. I have played with it. No. I don't know why I don't have it. Again, I don't need sound real bad, but... got Ethernet. I need Ethernet. I need power. Now you probably can't hear me over there. I'm used to having my mic and I don't have it. I know that. And, where's my cable for the sound? Didn't put it back. That's gonna make a big pop. Turn it off. Okay, now I see Which one is the green one? Maybe I could put in back here. It won't reach. It's not quite long enough to go any other way but straight. Okay. Turn that light over. That's mostly so I can see my tools. I really probably should have checked the doesn't make things better, does it? I really should have checked the I don't have, let's see, I think there's a real basic server install on here that doesn't require internet. Let's find out. Put it in here and boot it up. It works fine. See if there's anything in the DVD drive. Oh great, it doesn't want to come out. Or I think it's just a CD drive. Yep, I have my opener. There we go. Let's get to business here. I don't need to test the media. So we'll go straight into the boot up. Yeah, it's empty like it should be. Where I can open the lid on that. It's a big old plastic toolbox down there that I was standing on. But, wait a minute. This is probably this. This is a 64. I think this may only have, 64-bit version. So I don't have what I need to do that anyway. Dang. Forgot. I knew this already. Let's find out if this other one's 64-bit. I was actually just thinking about putting Fedora server on here, or the Bane might be better. We'll let you know since this is. Oh yeah, this doesn't have but like 512 megabyte of RAM. It would have to be the Bane. Now I'm already in a lot more work than I was thinking, because I don't have I've got Fedora 28 Mate on the other USB stick, and that's all I've got ready to go. I would have to, this one won't boot up. It's got a broken operating system. Let's see. can hook up. Yeah, I'm gonna hook up to this other machine now and see what it is I can do with it. Being hooked up if it can't be used. Oh, I need to put it on this other one anyway. This one could be 64-bit is what I'm thinking. Thank you. power switch is already on. It's kind of good for me to be out here reminding me to check on that battery, because my timer doesn't work on my battery charger. It doesn't automatically shut off. I did set an alarm on this phone that I'm recording on, though. That's so Ben is missing or corrupt. Doesn't want to start up at all. That's weird. Maybe that's just for the message I'm getting, because it's a 32-bit machine. It may not. It's BIOS. I don't know. I think, yeah, the BIOS would probably make a difference on what kind of. I don't think it has a CD in it or anything. Oh. Well, it says ISO Linux bin. It should have said something about XP if it was trying to boot to the hard drive. I'm having trouble with, you know, cuticles trouble here. Gotta look pretty, you know. Making a video. Yeah, they will tear way back if you don't cut them off when you feel them. It's actually getting a little warm in here now. The heater's running up there by the washer. If our weather gets from freezing to 70. It was 70 degrees yesterday. I was out here when it. For a couple of hours, and it was 70 before I went out. I don't have anything to drink. Okay, so, but I do have mosquitoes. I can feel them getting bit, and I just saw one. Alright, that, I don't know how many. You're supposed to make them go away, Mr. Candle. Okay, let's hit Control Delete and see if I can get into BIOS and do something about that. And then I'll have to. F12. This one may not. Oh, boot menu is F10. I really wanted F10. Let's see if it could. Huh. It really seems there's something wrong with that. I just used it so I know it works. Put it in the other one and see. Could be something weird about that USB. There is one on the back. I'll try the top one. There's two on the front there. I'm going to hit F10 this time. Nope. I'll try it in the back in a minute, but let's see what happens. I think it'll try to boot XP. I don't have any other media. Boot media out here. I don't think I finished. I was thinking about putting a really the Bane on here and then put ZoneMinder on here and plug a webcam into it. That's what I was thinking about. And I have to make a cable long enough for it to like reach anywhere besides right in here. But my webcams aren't. I was thinking about sticking it outside of the where it'd have to be outside of the garage door. You can, you know, watch the driveway. And, but it would have to be inside of something to protect it from the weather, and then it would probably overheat. Okay, no boot device. It would probably overheat like that. Oh, it rebooted instead of shutting down. Oh, there it went. Let's just try it first. If it does the same thing, then I'll know that it ain't gonna work. Won't really know why, but I'll know it ain't gonna work. I guess it wasn't through shutting down. There we go. What's it doing? going on and shutting back off. You turn the power off and turn it back on. Let's see. You know, that USB stick was in the slot I had it in. There's two down low and two up high, and I just put it in the high one. I had to flip it, so I think maybe it's broken. It allowed me to put it in backwards. Yeah. That's weird. This thing may be jacked up. No, it doesn't like the USB stick in the back. No? Doesn't like anything. I'm gonna unplug the power too for a minute. Something needs to be reset, I think. I don't remember it acting up like that. And now I try to boot up. Let's see what happens. When as soon as I plugged it in, it booted up. Maybe something wrong with the power switch. Something like that happened to my mom's machine and there was a power switch. Hit the reset button, see if that does anything. It's going on and off. I don't remember that it did that. It might have, and I just forgot. I was just a little confused about which way I was turning the stick, the USB stick. Oh, I guess it's off now. There we go. I don't know how long that thing will record. It quit on me the last time I tried to make a video with it. I didn't expect it. Did about an hour, almost an hour. I guess that's how long, 53 minutes or something. So, now I'm pissed. I don't know if there's anything going crazy about this thing. Well, it doesn't boot to USB anyway, so this USB, I'm almost certain. So, the IBM was beginning to, it was just making noise. It wasn't acting up, so. Yeah, if I was going to shut each, do whatever, something different, then I'm looking at my, I don't know what's the deal with that one, but I don't want to mess with it if it's going to give me trouble like that. Turn it off and use that power cable on this one. Maybe after that other one sets a while, it'll be alright again, but I don't want to fool with it now. When I fool with that, it'll be when I'm got everything else that's important done. Cables. Sound cable come loose. Just just make it, but don't just make it. Colors look so similar in the dim light. So if I was gonna put anything in here, it would be me install on anything or mess with anything. IBM, because I do know it'll work. It was just making fan noise. That's why I couldn't stand it in my room anymore. I don't think it even acted up. I can't. It seemed like it acted up. No, I don't guess it did really act up. Just for making fan noise. I don't put these cables somewhere where it doesn't bother me. That has to reach too, so I can use it. That's the other thing. And that would be something important. It has to reach. I'm going to stop the video and go in and get my CD set and see if I have, let's see, I know Fedora 29 will run on it. I had to, let's see, did I put, I don't remember if I put 28 or 29 on it. There is a 386 version. Oh yeah, I haven't put it on anything yet. I was going to do that after I set up my the other one that's 64-bit, the one that's, because I don't want to, I only have two sticks. Yeah, and since you have to do, I forgot, with the net install, you have to download it. If I, you know, I don't want to have to download. It takes 30, 45 minutes to download everything when you put much, your desktop on there. So, I thought I was turning it off. Okay, I gotta think all this through. Okay, so, yeah, even if I wanted to put Fedora on here, it would take a long time if the speed is slow like I think it is. So I'll go get my CDs. They're just not gonna have anything very new on them is what it is, what I was thinking. The bank's great for servers, especially. You know, well, it's lighter weight, but I don't like having to work administrated. It's harder for me because I'm used to the bank. I mean, the Fedora, and it's the way it works with the well, DNF now, but it works pretty much like. You know. So anyway, I'm gonna stop the camera and then I'll come back and fiddle with it just a little longer while I'm waiting on this battery.